Hello, and welcome to this YouTube video on projection welding in the resistance welding playlist. To begin with, let me start by sharing the screen so you can follow along with the PowerPoint presentation. My name is Girish Kelkar, and I am a welding consultant working as WJM Technologies, which stands for Welding and Joining of Materials. Additional information about my consulting and training services is on the web at welding-consultant.com. Today, we're going to look at the topic of projection welding, which is a variant of resistance welding, similar to parallel gap welding, which is another variant that we have reviewed in another video before. Projection welding is a process where we use a change in design of the components to focus the welding heat. I'm showing you over here a schematic on the left, which shows two components being joined. One is thicker than the other and with two electrodes, and the current is flowing uniformly across the interface. However, sometimes it happens that one of the components is too big or too conductive and is not able to heat up enough to form a weld. So what we want to do is we want to have a design which includes a projection as shown on the right-hand side. And that helps to focus the energy at a certain location and forces the larger component to get hot enough at the same time to form a weld. The projection design also helps to localize the welds. If you want a weld to form in a specific location, then also projection welding is very helpful. General design guidelines, projections cannot be too shallow. The bump or the dimple or the dome that you're making cannot be too shallow, otherwise it loses its effectiveness. It cannot be too sharp, otherwise it'll blow up like a fuse. So you have to come up with the good proportions. Oftentimes does require some amount of iterative work to come to that final design. Here's an example of stamp projection. You can see a component on the right where you can see three dimple projections. So spot projections are usually referred to as dimple projections. If these projections were all along the length of the component, they would be referred to as rail projections. So these dimple projections, and these are two guide bushings. So the three dimple projections have been stamped into this component. The dimple projections are, to start with, are based on the thickness of the thinner part to which this component is welded to. So based on the thickness of the other component, which continues to be the sheet, you can have the height of the projections, height of the dimple, the diameter of the dimple, which is going to be 2 to 3 times the thickness, and then the diameter of the electrode, which is then 2 or 3 times the diameter of the dimple itself. The guidelines above are starting points for evaluation. It is quite common for projection designs to have 1 or 2 iterations before you can finalize the design based on the requirements and limitations of the equipment. There are other options to make projections. As I've shown before, you can do stamped a projection, you can machine a projection, you can coin a projection, and you can also use a corner of the component itself, the component design itself, as a projection. So projection design and manufacturing process can be suited for that particular component. Here are some examples of cross sections of the welds with different types of projections. This is a cross section with a stamp projection, machine projection, coin projection, and corner projection. You will notice that in most situations, the welds formed in projection welding is a solid state bond. Now, we have already discussed what's a solid state bond in an earlier video in resistance welding on types of bonds. So these three are solid state bonds. There is no fusion at the interface. The coin projection over here, we see a beginning of some amount of fusion as the projection is consumed and potentially becomes a nugget. Another interesting aspect of projections is the use of projection design to squeeze out plating at the interface. It is a quite a common application for copper components to be welded together. However, copper oxidizes very easily. So oftentimes copper components are tin plated to prevent oxidation. But on the other hand, we do not want the tin plating in the weld because the tin is a low melting component. And if the tin remains in the weld at the interface and reacts with copper, it forms brittle copper tin intermetallics. So on one hand, we want the tin on the copper components to keep them from oxidizing. But on the other hand, we want the tin to be squeezed out or removed before welding. And the best way to do that is to use a projection. The projection design, the dome shape, helps to initiate heating right at the tip of the dome. And as the dome collapses, the tin starts melting at the tip and then keeps getting squeezed out. So towards the end of the weld, the tin has been squeezed out to the edges of the projection, and we can see that tin accumulating over here, whereas the solid interface over here kind of forms a strong copper-to-copper solid-state bond. So this is a very effective way of dealing with tin plating in welding of copper components. In summary, projection designs provide heat balance by making sure that the larger of the two components also gets sufficiently hot during welding. The primary reason for projections design is to provide good heat balance, because it is quite common that you are trying to weld a larger or a thicker component or a bigger component to a smaller component, or in some cases, you are trying to weld a more conductive alloy to a less conductive alloy. And in that case, you would make the projection on the more conductive alloy, because that's the one which is going to have a hard time getting hot enough for welding. Projection also helps to localize the weld in a design. So if you want the welds to happen in a certain location, then the projection designs help with that as well. So you can actually focus or make sure that you can find one, two, or three, or four of these projections at the exact same place where you wanted them to be. There are multiple manufacturing options available to form projections, including stamping, machining, coining, and corner projections. All of them are quite commonly used. I would say stamping and machining are probably two of the most common. The final reason why projections can be used is projection welding process helps to squeeze out the tin plating when welding tin plated components. So as I mentioned in the previous slide, we want the tin to be there to protect the copper from oxidation. At the same time, we want the tin to be removed right from the weld location. And the projection welding design allows us to do that at the same time as the weld is being made. So that makes it very efficient and very clean way of making a solid state bond. Keep in mind that projection is a very viable option in resistance welding. It is very quite commonly used. The only downside of the projection is you actually have to make a projection. So now that becomes a design step or a manufacturing step before the components can be brought for welding. So that is one of the downsides, but there are a lot of pluses, and that is one of the reasons why projection welding is actually very popular in resistance welding. Thank you for your time. If you're interested in learning more about welding and joining, please subscribe to this YouTube channel, The Weld Nugget, by clicking the subscribe button below. And videos on specific topics are in playlists on this channel, including playlists for laser welding, ultrasonic welding, metallurgy, and arc welding. I want to thank you again for your time and wish you the very best.